Hey, this is Dustin from Streamlabs. Today, I'm going to show you how to download, install, and quickly go live with Streamlabs OBS. Before we get started, let's get into a few of the reasons why many streamers have Streamlabs OBS as their go-to choice for streaming software. Streamlabs OBS takes four windows that are essential for every streamer: chat, live stream preview, recent events, and OBS scene switcher, and condenses them into one tab in Streamlabs OBS. This preserves valuable screen real estate, reduces CPU load, and you can lower CPU load to leverage a higher quality stream. The Streamlabs theme library is the largest library of themes and widgets in the world. The theme library provides $1 million worth of content available for free with one-click installation. With Streamlabs OBS, you can set up to go live in mere minutes with our optimization feature, quickly import scenes and settings from OBS, and have easy one-click installation of themes and widgets. First, you'll want to go to streamlabs.com and click on the download button located on the Streamlabs website homepage. After you've downloaded Streamlabs OBS, go to your downloads folder and double-click on the executable file to begin the installation process. Follow the prompts for the license agreement, then choose where on your system you'd like to designate the program to be installed. After the installation is complete, you can click Finish and have Streamlabs OBS launch automatically if the Run Streamlabs OBS checkbox is checked. Once Streamlabs OBS starts, you'll be prompted to log into your platform of choice, Twitch, YouTube, or Mixer. After logging in with your credentials, you may need to authorize Streamlabs OBS for the platform. After authorization, if you have existing scene collections within Streamlabs.com, you'll be shown which scene collections will be automatically imported into Streamlabs OBS. Click Continue, and you'll be brought to the Streamlabs OBS Editor tab. If you've used OBS Studio, you'll be prompted to import from OBS or start fresh. We're going to start fresh to get started on a clean slate. Next, we can choose to add widgets, which are a variety of Streamlabs tools that help your stream right out of the box for streamers. We'll skip these for now, since we'll be taking advantage of the free library widget setups. After that is the option for optimization. This lets the software analyze your internet connection and hardware setup and chooses the best options for you. You can tweak these settings later at any time. Since we want to get started with streaming right away, we can click Start. Once the optimization process finishes, click Next. Now, we're on the Editor tab and can get started on installing one of the great library scene and widget themes. So let's click on the Themes tab on the top left. We want to get up and running right away, so we'll choose the Clean Swirls scene theme, go to the top right, and click Install Overlay. After installing the scene theme, we'll be brought back to the Editor tab with the Swirls theme installed. On the bottom left, we can see all the scenes available. We have a Starting Soon scene for right when we go live. We also have a Live Screen scene, Be Right Back scene, Stream Ending scene, and Offline scene. Our Live Screen scene has a background to show what it would look like with the live gameplay, but we can delete this, so we'll select it and delete it with the Delete key. After you've started your game, you can use a game or window capture source to capture your gameplay for your stream. We'll drag this beneath all the other sources so that it doesn't cover our webcam or other overlay elements. We want our Starting Soon scene to be the first thing that viewers see, so we'll select it. To make sure we can keep track of any new followers, tips, or hosts, we'll click on the Live tab on the top left. We also want to make sure that we can see what all our viewers type in chat while we're streaming, so we'll click on this arrow on the right border of Streamlabs OBS to see our chat window. Right before we go live, let's throw up a tipping link on our profile, so we'll go to our Dashboard tab and navigate to Donation Settings. Click on PayPal and put in your PayPal email so any tips can go directly to that account. Then, we can copy the tipping link URL right above and go to our profile and add it, so that viewers can click it and tip us. Now we're ready to go live, so we'll click the Go Live button and we'll be asked to set a stream title and game. After that's all set, click confirm and go live, and now you're streaming. Be sure to download Streamlabs OBS by visiting streamlabs.com and hop into our Discord server at discord.gg/stream for live community support. Check out the links in the description below.